What's up, guys? Rossi Morielli here from American Air Gunner, and it's time for a vault hunt. Now, when you open up a vault, there's all kinds of beautiful things inside. Well, like this vault over here that has a lot of air guns in it, our vault hunts have some great hunts from the past 10 years with some of our favorite hunters. This week, we're going to check out Steve Criner out in Oklahoma as he's going hunting at nighttime for coons. Raccoon hunting with the Hatsan BT65 22 caliber. This is a very fun hunt. Steve is a wild man, and when you get him out at nighttime, it's always a good time. Check this out.
Hey everybody, welcome back to American Air Gunner. We got our Hatsan BT65, our 22 caliber PCP, down in Oklahoma on the Wildcat Springs Ranch. We're gonna be hunting with Marshall Bryant. He's the manager here at the ranch. He's with kickandbehunting.com. What's really cool for me is he's having trouble with his coons at all these deer feeders. Wildcat Springs Ranch has all kinds of feeders, and that means all kinds of coons. So Marshall, with his depredation permit, he has to go through all means possible to kill all the coyotes, kill all the coons that's giving him trouble, the possums. He has to take care of it, because this time of year, especially the does, you know, they got fawns. He don't want his does stressed out, and that's where we fit in. These quiet air guns like the BT65, we can slip into these feeders and shoot these coons. Hopefully we have a long night of night hunting coons in the summertime with our BT65. We're just waiting for dark. We're gonna hammer down. Ready, boys. Grab your gun, Marshall. Get to the road, Kevin. Got him?
That is going to be the most exciting air gun hunt ever. Folks, he was not kidding.
Woo!
I mean, got a raccoon, got bit by a raccoon.
Boys.
That's probably the most exciting coon hunt I've ever been on, and I've been hunting my whole life.
Nice young sow. She's probably, you know, based off her size, she's probably a two-year-old coon. You know, right now is a good time to call coons because their pups are old enough to survive without their mamas. So what that means is when you're out here shooting coons, you ain't got to worry about starving pups. As much as we don't want these coons around the feeders here at the Wildcat Springs Ranch, we don't want no pups starving either. So let's go get some more, buddy.
Let's do it.
We just made a heck of a stand. We called in that coon at 5 yards. We should have a whole night of action with these air guns. So,
hey, man, there's an armadillo right there.
Let's do it. Dude, I've been trying to kill a freaking armadillo with a pellet rifle for like 2 years. It's on. Hold on, don't run him off. You guys ready? How about that, Marshall Bryant? Going down a road, we see an armadillo, and Marshall's like, shoot that armadillo. Well, the reason why is because if you walk out in this pasture, especially like right here where it's brush hogged real nice and it's kind of groomed right here by the lodge, you'll walk over there and you'll dang near break your ankle if you don't watch. Them things cause some damage.
They start our holes under our high fence around here, you know, and the
armadillo starts to hole, then the coyote comes along, smells where the armadillo dug the hole, coyote starts using the hole, and the bobcat uses the hole, then the deer find the hole.
Just on and on and on, so.
Right in the ear, in one ear and out the other.
Oh, yeah. We're going to keep calling coons.
Yeah, we'll kill more of them for
We'll kill all them we can for
get
sure.
Little fence-rooted little devils.